गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल स्टडी ज्योग्राफी फर्स्ट चैप्टर आवर एनवायरनमेंट। ह्यूमन एंड अदर लिविंग बींग्स लिव्स ऑन अर्थ। द फेवरेबल कंडीशन दैट मेक्स लाइफ पॉसिबल ऑन अर्थ फ्रॉम द एनवायरनमेंट, लैंड वाटर एंड एयर टुगेदर विद द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक प्लांट एंड एनिमल मेक अप एन आवर एनवायरनमेंट। An environment consists of living and non-living things with which an organism may interact. Our environment is made up of different components. These components can be classified into two broad categories: natural environment and man-made environment. Here in the picture you can see the natural environment and man-made environment. The natural environment: all gifts of nature such as land, water, air, plant and animal forms a part of natural environment. It includes biotic and abiotic components. Abiotic components consist of non-living things like land, water, air, rock, etc. Biotic components consist of plant and animal which are living. Here you can see in the picture biotic and abiotic factor. The four domains or realms of the natural environment: the lithosphere, the hydrosphere, the atmosphere, the biosphere. The lithosphere, the outermost solid layer of the earth consists of soil and rock minerals, is called lithosphere. It includes not only the land surface but also ocean floor. The term lithosphere means rocky crust. The average thickness of lithosphere is about 100 kilometers. The thickness of lithosphere is greater in the continent, about 32 kilometers, then on ocean floor about 8 kilometers. They are made up of various types of rocks and minerals. It has mountains, plateau, plains, valley, river and ocean. Here in the picture you can see Earth lithosphere. Lithosphere provides land for building of houses, road, factories and agriculture. We also get various minerals from it. The hydrosphere. Hydrosphere is the part of Earth's surface covered by water. About 71% of Earth's surface is covered with water, hence it is called watery planet. All the water bodies such as ocean, sea, lake, river, waves, ice cap, glacier, groundwater and fresh water together make up the hydrosphere. Fresh water is used for domestic agriculture and industrial activities. It is also used to generate electricity and for transportation. Hydrosphere is present on land through the process of water cycle. Ocean provide us with food and mineral. Here you can see water cycle. The atmosphere. The blanket of air that envelops the earth is called atmosphere. It is considered to up to 1,600 kilometers from the surface of the earth. The gravitational force of the earth holds the atmosphere around it. It is the mixture of many gases such as nitrogen 78% and oxygen 21%, and the rest includes 1% substance like argon, carbon dioxide, water vapor, dust and smoke particles. The atmosphere prevents the sun harmful rays from reaching the earth's surface. It controls the temperature and pressure and humidity and sunshine. Change in atmosphere produce change in weather and climate. Without the atmosphere, our earth would be barren like other planet. Here you can see layer of atmosphere picture. Biosphere, the narrow zone of earth where land, lithosphere, water, hydrosphere and air atmosphere interact with each other to support life is called biosphere. It comes from Greek word bio means life and Latin word sphere meaning the total range from microscopic organism to huge trees, animal and human being. The great variety of life on the earth is called biological diversity or biodiversity. The type of animal that live in area depends largely on the type of crop grown over there. Plant life in turn is determined mainly by climate. Trees, for example, grow tall and thick where it is warm and rainy. Here in the picture you can see biosphere. Ecosystem. From the pole to equator, life can be found underground, in water, in air, and on land. Each ecosystem is formed due to its interaction with living organism and the physical environment in which they live. It can be large as the rainforest, grassland, desert, lake, river, or small as a pond. A pond ecosystem may contain tiny plants such as diatom, green algae, and very small animal like rotifer. Most of the ecosystem are complex and contains thousands of interacting species. These species interact with each other and abiotic environment. In every ecosystem, there is a perfect balance or equilibrium in transfer of energy and matter between different components. This is known as ecological balance. Here you can see ecosystem. Human environment. It is formed by human being and their creation such as road, bridge, etc., etc. and the social, economical, political and other ecosystem in which they live. These influence decide the lifestyle, occupation, dress, food habits and nature of habit of human being. Earlier, human lives in harmony with nature. They lived simple life. They could fulfill their basic need from the nature around them. With the invention of wheel, transportation became easier and faster. Later, the trade and commerce developed. With the scientific and technological advancement, humans succeed in controlling and dominating nature. Here you can see human environment. Human and environment interaction. The physical environment provide human being with different materialistic need. Activities like farming, fishing, forestry and mining still require raw material without which no society can survive or progress. Human being and their activities possess a great danger to environment since the start of human cultivation. People have used the nature for its existence. they have exploited and misused it to a certain extent. Thus, the balance of the environment have been disturbed. When the disturbance made by human were less, nature could repair itself, but now the forests are being cut down at a faster rate. Industrial development is polluting our environment. A perfect balance between nature and human environment is a need of our. We should understand that human race could not survive if we do not live in harmony with nature. Thus, it is important to maintain balance in nature. Here you can see cutting down the tree in forest. Thank you. Hope you like this chapter.